it is a staff writing or technique which includes magical as well as supernatural events narrated realistically without any doubt about improbability of the events. So in the magical realism, so the writers, they talk about the magic and the fantasy, which cannot happen, that they can imagine, they imagine in their writing and they express the idea in the writing. So it questions the nature of realities and draw attention to the act of creation by using a new combination of fact and fancy as well. I have already mentioned. So the first, the magical realism was originated in the fictional writing of Spanish American writers in the mid 20th century, and it began in the 1940s with the publication of two important novels, Man of Maze by writer Miguel Angel Astruer, who was a Guatemalan, and The Kingdom of This World, the Cuban writer Alejo Carpenter, and the South American, Latin American writer Gabriel Garcia Marquez, he was influenced by Alejo Carpenter, and he wrote 100 Years of Solitude, which is a magical realism. And here, in this magical realism, the setting is realistic, and some of the episodes are fantastic. So this, in this 100 Years of Solitude, it talks about a city of Makonda. It talks about the first, they give the picture of utopian society, and that utopian society later it was ruined by the some political and the society and natural forces, which actually the people in that area, they believe that their society or their place to be one of the best and the utopian society, but in the later stage it was prevented by the politicals and society at large. This is what happens in the magical realism. And it is a multi-generational epic that tells story of the rise and fall, as I have already said, the rise and fall of the city of Makonda, and life and death, riches and poverty, triumph and tragedy of the town of Makonda through the history of Wanda family. So this the story of this city is told through the life story of this Wanda family. So in this story, it was narrated through the family of this Wanda. It is through this technique that the history of Latin America, fictionalized through the novel, pertains to reality and yet tends to deconstruct the notion of reality. So this is actually what happens in the magical realism writing. Another writer, one of the notable writers from India, Salman Rushdie, he wrote Midnight's Children, which is also a magical realism. So it was published in 1980. So here, in this story, there is a character, Salim Sinai, a boy who was born at the stroke of midnight on the same day that India gained its freedom from England. So here, the writer Salman Rushdie, actually, he is trying to tell the story of how India struggled for its independence and how it got its freedom. And through the character Salim Sinai, he is narrating the story, the hardship faced by the India in order to gain the independence. So Midnight Children use magical realism as a device to combine history with Rushdie's fictional to his own history. So here, history is reduced to micro narratives. Now, I'm going to talk some of the problem playwrights. And Henrik Ibsen, he is termed as the father of realism, and the second most influential playwrights of all time after Shakespeare. So we have learned about the playwrights such as Shakespeare, and we all know that he was one of the greatest dramatists.